Hi, welcome to Arts again. Today I'm guiding you in my hometown. That is not Siena. Probably I lied to you sometimes. I'm not living in Siena, but I live in a little town nearby, Rapolano. It's just on the south of Siena, between Siena and Perugia, we have to say. And between also the Clay Hills and the Val di Chiana Valley. The name, the full name of the town is Rapolano Terme because we have the thermal baths here from the Etruscan Roman times, and even town is the primary economical source of the town. But another one, a very important one, was the Travertino marble stone. The travertino is a kind of stone made of calcium carbonate that during the centuries is pressed on the underground and becomes a stone, white or brownish or pinkish, light pinkish stone. We can have a lot of colors in different blocks of marble, and it's a very peculiar stone because we don't know actually which kind of color, which kind of quality of marble we can find when we cut off these huge blocks of travertino stone. The block can be a good one or can be full of flaws, so it can be used in different kind of buildings or in different kind of ways depending on its quality. It can be with different colors of different veins all along the stone. This is its peculiarity, but it's also very difficult in terms of trading these stones in different projects and destinating these pieces of marble in different projects. The travertino stone is mostly used in the building trade, especially now with the mechanization of the quarries. We know for sure that the Etruscan in this area used to cover the rooms inside the tumuli, inside the tombs, with travertino marble. And it's just the only area when it's been done. The Romans, they used travertino for their buildings a lot of times. We have this stone, a very old one, it's from the second century of the Common Era, with these strange numbers and letters, and it's just the number or letter of the block of stone, like now the workers, the quarrymen, used to write down some indication, like a code, to designate the stone to a proper project. Also, the Romans did the same, used to do the same. That's why we have this strange inscription. The first document that we have concerning the travertino stone from Rapolano is the one of the facade of the Church of Provenzano in Siena in 1596. The city of Siena bought a lot of travertino marble stone to cover the facade of the new building of the Provenzano, the Church of St. Mary of Provenzano. From this moment on, it's been used a lot of times, especially in the last century. So I'm showing you in these photos different buildings train stations covered with travertino stone from Rapolano, but after the crisis of the building trade, we have to say that we have a kind of archaeological site of these factories in all along a street that we call it the Strada delle Cave. So Quarry Street, not far from Serre, a fraction of Rapolano. You can see here a wonderful landscape that is being used in a lot of advertisings or music videos. Because when you abandon Travertino Quarry, the waters come up, flows up, and there are these kind of lakes, the vegetations come through, so it's really, really wonderful. I'm inviting you here to see with your own eyes. You can do this street by foot, running, or with your bike. We can have a lot of hikes or trekkings all along. So I'm waiting you here in Rapolano. See you next time. Bye bye with Art Arts.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a